Good afternoon. Good afternoon. It is indeed a good afternoon. Before we begin our liturgy this afternoon, just a couple of points of language. Our opening song on page 27 will be leading in Latin. There is an English translation. When we do the verses, we'll be doing those verses, the choir, leading those in English. The other song of multiple languages is the second communion song, Pescador, Lord, When You Came, on page 41. This song will be leading entirely in Spanish. There is an English there as a translation, but we'll be singing Pescador, Lord, When You Came, in Spanish. And to prepare our hearts and minds, we have a prelude based on the words of the famous prayer of St. Francis, Lord, make me an instrument of your peace.
Lord, may Please be seated. On behalf of Archbishop Kiley and Archbishop Dolan, I wish to extend a happy St. Patrick's Day to all of Irish descent. God bless all of you, and thank you for your presence here and honoring that holy day of obligation. I would like to read briefly a couple letters. First one is, Dear Archbishop Listecki, the appointment of two new auxiliary bishops for the Archdiocese of Milwaukee is a cause of immense joy for the entire local church, entrusted to your pastoral care. The generous assistance they will give as successors of the apostles in preaching the gospel, in sanctifying God's people through the administration of the sacraments, and in exercising the duty of governing with fatherly concern will be greatly appreciated by you and likewise by the priests, deacons, women, and men religious, as well as by the lay faithful of our great archdiocese. The Holy Father's choice of Father Jeffrey Haines and Father James Schuerman, seasoned and highly respected pastors, each with a wealth of experience and spiritual leadership, should engender great pride among the diocesan priests who witnessed two of their own promoted to the Episcopal order. It should also be a motive for heartfelt thanksgiving on the part of the whole archdiocesan family that, through the ministry of Peter, God, our merciful Father, never fails to raise up faithful shepherds in the image of his Son, Jesus, the Good Shepherd. So allow me then to join my voice to the chorus of well-wishers to Bishop-elect Haines and Schuerman on the day of their ordination to the episcopate. May the gifts of the Holy Spirit, which they will receive in abundance, redound to the good of the church in southeastern Wisconsin and beyond. With the assurances of my union in prayer on March 17th, I remain fraternally yours, James Cardinal Harvey. Cardinal Harvey gifted the cathedral with that silver cross, which is on the altar. And certainly his heart has never left this archdiocese. A second letter, Your Excellency, my brother, dear Archbishop Listecki, congratulations to you and the archdiocese as you welcome two stellar new bishops, Jeffrey and James. I questioned the infallibility of Pope John Paul II when he named me a bishop. But my confidence is now restored as Pope Francis has chosen so well in nominating these two revered priests as successors to the apostles. My own regret is that I cannot be back home in the archdiocese I love for this festive day. You, dear son of St. Stanislaus and St. Casimir, may be forgiven for not realizing that this high holy day of St. Patrick has particular prominence here in New York, requiring my patience on the steps of his cathedral to review a parade of 4 hours in his honor. Solidarity in love, faith, and prayer with all of you, fraternally yours in Christ, Timothy Cardinal Dolan, Archbishop of New York. Tim also gifted the cathedral with a picture of himself. In a particular way, when we come together for these wonderful events, many of you may not realize the sacrifices made by many of the bishops who are here. And some of you may not even realize who they are or where they're from. So allow me a few minutes to introduce you to them. First of all, Archbishop Christophe Pierre, who is seated there in the prominent cathedral chair. He is my new BFF, my best friend forever, because he has helped us to gain these two wonderful priests to assist in the episcopate here in the Archdiocese of Milwaukee. He so wonderfully represents Pope Francis and his spirit here in the United States and has certainly captured the heart of many of the bishops in the U.S. Catholic Conference. Please let us welcome We are honored also in a very special way to have the presence of Cardinal Blaise Supich. Cardinal Supich is seated over here, right? His red, vibrant red zucchetto is there. Cardinal Supich is the Metropolitan of the region. So he is the Cardinal Archbishop of Chicago, and certainly we look to him for leadership and guidance as we look to work together in Wisconsin, Illinois, and Indiana. Certainly an honor and privilege for us to have a Cardinal Archbishop of the Church here celebrating with us today. God bless you, thank you. Now the prelates from the Providence of Wisconsin who are here are Bishop Robert Morlino. Bob is seated right next to Cardinal Supich. David Ricken of Green Bay. David is over to the right of that person that we all know, once auxiliary here, but now Bishop William Callahan, Bishop of La Crosse, and Bishop James Powers. And James is right over there on the right-hand side. Thank you very much. These are the men that I work with at the WCC and that helped to fashion and form the Catholic presence here in Wisconsin. We are also very privileged and honored that the prelates from Chicago, the auxiliaries to Cardinal Supich, are here. And that is, in the front here, Bishop George Rassus, Father Frank Kane, Bishop Joseph Perry, who we all know well here in Milwaukee, for he was a priest of the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, and then stolen from us by Cardinal Francis George. We still depend upon him for his great advice that he offers to us, and very happy to have him return. Bishop Andrew Vippich was here from Chicago. Andrew is in the back there. And Bishop Alberto Rojas from Chicago, all auxiliaries in Chicago. And the prelates from Illinois are Bishop David Malloy, who is also one of ours, former priest here of Milwaukee, and former pastor of St. Francis de Sales Church in Lake Geneva, where Bishop Schuerman was pastor in Lake Geneva. So the way to the episcopate is through Lake Geneva. I just went like that. Bishop Thomas Papraki, Springfield. Tom was a couple years behind me in the seminary, and we go way back to our days in high school together. Bishop Joseph Siegel, who was auxiliary in Joliet, and we are happy that they have joined us here. The prelates from Indiana, retired Bishop Emeritus of Gary, Bishop Dale Melchick, who is here, and we're happy to have his presence. And a familiar name for all of us is Bishop Fabian Breskowitz, another priest of the Archdiocese of Milwaukee. And Bishop Breskowitz is the former emeritus of Lincoln, Nebraska. God bless you, Fabian. Thank you for joining us here. And last is Auxiliary Bishop Joy Alapat from the Cyril Malabar Church. He's the one who's well-dressed, so would you stand up, please? Just looks very, just very wonderful. So we are very fortunate and honored that they would be here. And of course, our two assisting co-consecrators are individuals who are known to all of us. Right to my right is Bishop Donald Hine, now the Bishop of Gary, former auxiliary here in Milwaukee. And to my left, obviously an individual we all know, care and love, Auxiliary Bishop Emeritus, Bishop Richard Skilba. God bless all of them and thank you for your presence. And let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and the great mercy which is ours through Christ.
Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who out of the abundance of your untold grace alone choose to raise these priests, your servants, to the ministry of the high priesthood. On this day, the memorial of Bishop St. Patrick, grant that they may carry out worthily the office of bishop, and under your governance, in all things, they may direct by word and example the people entrusted to their care. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Lectura del libro del profeta Jeremías. Y vino a mí la palabra del Señor. Antes que yo te formara en el seno materno, te conocí. Y antes que nacieras, te consagré. Te puse por profeta a las naciones. Entonces dije: ¡Ah, Señor Dios! No sé hablar, porque soy joven. Pero el Señor me dijo: no digas soy joven, porque a donde quiera que te envíe, irás. Y todo lo que te mande, dirás. Porque contigo estoy para librarte, declara el Señor. Entonces, el Señor extendió su mano y tocó mi boca. Y el Señor me dijo, yo he puesto mis palabras en tu boca. Palabra del Señor.
A reading from the first book of Peter. The end of all things is near. Therefore, be serious and discipline yourselves for the sake of your prayers. Above all, maintain constant love for one another, for love covers a multitude of sins. Be hospitable to one another without complaining. Like good stewards of the manifold grace of God, serve one another with whatever gifts each of you has received. Whoever speaks must do so as one speaking the very words of God. Whoever serves must do so with the strength that God supplies, so that God may be glorified in all things through Jesus Christ. To him belong the glory and the power forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While the crowd was pressing in on Jesus and listening to the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Gennesaret. He saw two boats there alongside the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have worked hard all night and have caught nothing, but at your command I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish and their nets were tearing. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come help them. They came and filled both boats so that the boats were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish that they had made seized him and all of those with him, and likewise James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching men." When they brought their boats to the shore, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Most Reverend Father, the Church of the Archdiocese of Milwaukee asks you to ordain this priest, Jeffrey Haines, to the responsibility of the episcopate.
Most Reverend Father, the Church of the Archdiocese of Milwaukee asks you to ordain this priest, James Schuerman, to the responsibility of the episcopate.
Have you the mandates from the Holy See?
We have.
Let them be read.
Your Eminence, Cardinal Supich, Your Excellency, Archbishop Listeki, Your Excellencies, Bishop Haing and Skilba, Your Excellencies, Auxiliary Bishops Elect, Haines and Schuerman, my brothers, archbishops and bishops, dear priests, deacons, consecrated religious, lay faithful of the Church in Milwaukee, dear friends, I am very happy to join with you today as two beloved local priests of this Archdiocese, Father Jeffrey Haines and Father James Schuerman, are ordained to the fullness of the priesthood and begin their ministry as auxiliary bishops of the chief shepherd of this local church, Archbishop Jerome Listeki. We thank them for generously answering the call to greater service in the church and are confident that they will bring the good news of Jesus Christ to the countless souls they will touch. Today, being the memorial of St. Patrick, Bishop, and mindful of the parades and celebration accompanying it, a day on which everyone, it seems, is Irish. I am Breton myself. You know, the Breton speaks Gaelic, speaks Irish. I could not help but notice that divine providence has brought us all together to Milwaukee, which, despite the passing of time and the many changes that go with it, can still rightly be called Brew City, part of a prayer ascribed to St. Patrick seems especially appropriate for each of us during this holy season of Lent, especially for our auxiliary bishops elect. I bind unto myself today the power of God to hold and lead, his eye to watch, his might to stay, his ear to hearken, to hearken to my need, the wisdom of my God to teach, his hand to guide, his shield to ward, the word of God to give me speech, his heavenly host to be my guard. Christ be with me, Christ within me, Christ behind me, Christ before me, Christ beside me, Christ to win me, Christ to comfort me and restore me, Christ beneath me, Christ above me, Christ in the hearts of all who love me, Christ in the mouth of friend and stranger. At this time, it gives me great joy to read for you the apostolic letters of appointment. As you know, these apostolic letters are written in Latin. So I suppose you prefer that I read it in a nice English translation. Francis, Bishop, servant of the servants of God, to our beloved son, Jeffrey Robert Haines, from the clergy of the Archdiocese of Milwaukee and rector there of the Cathedral St. John, the Evangelist, appointed auxiliary of the same Archdiocese and promoted to the titular see of Tagamuta, greetings and apostolic blessing. Located on Lake Michigan, that's correct, isn't it? Western Shore, the city of Milwaukee, which once upon a time witnessed your birth, now takes delight as it beholds your zeal as a pastor in proclaiming in that very place the gospel of Christ and in serving your brothers and sisters. Accordingly, when our venerable brother, Jerome Edward Listecki, Metropolitan Archbishop of Milwaukee, not long ago petitioned that an auxiliary bishop be granted him so as to pursue the salvation of souls in a more effective manner, we gladly granted his request. And so we judge you, beloved son, to be suitable for carrying out this ministry for correctly formed in the Catholic faith. You clearly manifest priestly virtues and pastoral experience. Therefore, upon consultation with the Congregation for Bishops, by virtue of our apostolic authority, we name you Bishop of the titular see of Tagamuta and at the same time appoint you auxiliary of the church in Milwaukee in accordance with the norms of canon law. Concerning your ordination, you may receive it from any Catholic bishop. This is not any Catholic bishop. The liturgical prescriptions being observed. However, prior to this, you must duly make the profession of faith and take the oath of fidelity to us and our successor. You made it, isn't it? Finally, beloved son, together with the prayerful intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, we beseech the Holy Spirit to enkindle and sustain your zeal with his grace. Indeed, it is our earnest desire that with a ready spirit you hasten to assist the ordinary of the beloved flock of Milwaukee, constantly teaching, especially families and young people, the true love of God and neighbor, for all things work for good for those who love God. Given at Rome at St. Peter's on the 25th day of the month of January, the Feast of the Conversion of St. Paul the Apostle, in the year of the Lord 2017, the fourth of our pontificate. and it is signed Francis. Second, Francis, Bishop, servant of the servants of God. To our beloved son James Schuerman, from the clergy of the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, appointed its auxiliary bishop and at the same time promoted to the titularcy of Girba, or Girba. Greetings and apostolic blessing. The pastoral concern of our office in guiding the Catholic Church necessitates that we grant readily to its bishops whatever, for the sake of the spiritual welfare of the Lord's flock, enables them to carry out even more effectively their ministry for the salvation of Christ's faithful. For this reason, we direct our attention to the needs of the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, whose ordinary our venerable brother, Jerome Edward Listecki, very recently requested that he might have the benefit of a new auxiliary to assist in the guidance of diocesan life. And so, beloved son, our thoughts turn to you, whom, given your specialization in spirituality, we judge to possess the requisite virtues for undertaking the episcopal responsibilities of sanctifying, teaching, and governing in the Church. Therefore, upon consultation with the Congregation for Bishops, by the fullness of our apostolic authority, by virtue of this letter, we appoint you Auxiliary Bishop of the Metropolitan Church of Milwaukee, promoting you to the titular see of Girba, at the same time granting to you all the due rights and imposing the relative obligations which are connected with this office. You may receive episcopal ordination from any Catholic bishop anywhere outside the city of Rome. This is not anywhere. The liturgical norms being observed. However, prior to this, you must make the profession of faith and take the oath of fidelity towards us and our successors in accordance with the norms of ecclesiastical law. Finally, beloved son, we beseech the Lord to assist you under the patronage of St. John the Apostle and Evangelist to open up carefully for the faithful the mysteries of the Word of God, so that they may draw from it with an enlightened understanding owing to what you zealously bring to the ears of all. Given to at Rome, at St. Peter's, on the 25th day of the month of January, in the year of the Lord 2017, the fourth of our pontificate. And it is signed Francis.
Blessed be God, who chose you in Christ to be filled with the Spirit of love. Blessed be God, who chose you in Christ to proclaim to all nations his deeds.
Blessed be God, who chose you in Christ to be filled with the Spirit of love.
Blessed be God, who chose you in Christ to proclaim to all nations his deeds.
We come to you, Lord Jesus, you have filled us with new life as children of the Father and one in you. Send forth your Holy Spirit, renew the face of the earth, renew the face of the earth.
Blessed be
My brothers, Jeff and Jim, I know what a shock it was when you received the phone call from the apostolic delegate telling you that Pope Francis has selected you as bishops. All sorts of reasons filtered, I'm sure, through your minds why you shouldn't be chosen. I am not prepared or ready. And yes, that's true, no one is ready. Peter wasn't ready when the Lord said to go out into the deep, to cast your nets. Or the words of Jeremiah, the prophet, who said, I don't know how to speak. Now notice I didn't say, I am too young. That certainly would have been a stretch. Or finally, I'm not worthy. And you know what? You're not. But every protest to the call that has been placed before you by the church starts with the word I. And believe me, if all assessments were placed on any bishop from the starting point of I, it's very obvious that no bishop would be capable of accepting the episcopal office. The very apostles themselves, called by Jesus and depicted in the stained glass windows that surround you this afternoon in this cathedral, were not prepared. They were not eloquent speakers, and certainly not worthy. But they did submit themselves to the Lord. For it is the Holy Spirit that guides the movement of the church, and all of us are but mere instruments. Like Paul states, it's no longer I that live, but the Lord who lives in me. For you are not alone, but Jesus Christ, who has called you, journeys with you for the sake of his church. Pope Francis reminded us early on his pontificate that a good shepherd must smell like his sheep. Although we all appreciate your attention to hygiene, the identification that you have with the people you serve is an avenue through which you present the gospel message. They will embrace the difficult aspects of the church's teaching through one who loves them and walks with them. Cherish for each other a love that is constant and intense, so that they view you as a living with them, sharing their sufferings and joys and declaring God's love for them. As Pope Francis said, at the core, it is always and only the love of Christ that generates faith and carries the church ahead. You both have been good pastors. The people you have served affirm that assessment. This will serve you as you exercise the office of bishop. Remember, it will not be you alone responding to the call, but your brother priests who have shared their lives and ministries with you. They have grown and developed the priestly sense that calls for self-sacrifice in the name of Christ's love. And they will continue to be models of service, following John's image of Jesus at the Last Supper, washing the feet of his disciples. And the deacons, who in the spirit of St. Francis have collaborated with you in addressing the needs of your people, the people that you serve. You will be carrying with you the experiences of those parish staff members and parishioners whose living faith have inspired and challenged you throughout your priestly service. The religious who have been such an influence on the faith of this archdiocesan community. Through their commitment to the evangelical councils, they will provide a source of spiritual strength for you in achieving the gospel mandate. And of course, your family and friends who have been examples of faith throughout your lives, who have nurtured your vocations and the source of your support for you as priest. They have walked with you throughout your lives, and I am confident they will be with you on this new journey in service to the church. The love they have shared shines through you both. Jeff, it's a blessing to have your mother, Maureen, and your father, Jim, here today with your family. And Jim, I know as a believer that your parents, Robert and Elizabeth, are smiling with the angels and share with your family the joy of this, your Episcopal ordination. Therefore, my brothers, put aside your own unworthiness and join yourself with those who have shared your priestly journey in the name of Jesus. So when you speak, speak as one uttering words sent from God. If you render service, do so as one whose service comes from the strength which God supplies. So that in all things, as was read today, God may be glorified through Jesus Christ, to whom belong glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Beloved, consider carefully the rank and nature in the church to which our brothers are about to be raised. Our Lord Jesus Christ, who was sent by the Father to redeem the human race, in turn sent 12 apostles into the world. They were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit to preach the gospel and to sanctify and govern all the peoples gathered into one flock. Moreover, so that this office might remain to the end of time, the apostles chose helpers for themselves. Through the laying on of hands, by which the fullness of the sacrament of holy orders is conferred, they handed on to them the gift of the Holy Spirit, which they had received from Christ. In that way, the tradition handed down from the beginning through the unbroken succession of bishops is preserved from generation to generation, and the work of the Savior continues on and grows even to our own times. In the bishop surrounded by his priest, our Lord Jesus Christ himself, having become high priest forever, is present among you. For through the ministry of the bishop, Christ himself never fails to proclaim the gospel and to administer the sacraments of faith to those who believe. Through the bishop's exercise of his duty as father, Christ himself adds new members to his body. Through the bishop's wisdom and prudence, it is Christ himself who leads you in your earthly pilgrimage towards eternal happiness. Gladly and gratefully, therefore, welcome our brothers whom we, the bishops, now admit into our college by the laying on of hands. Revere them as ministers of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. They have been entrusted with the task of bearing witness to the truth of the gospel and with the ministry of the Spirit and of justice. Remember the words Christ spoke to the apostles. Whoever listens to you listens to me, and whoever rejects you rejects me, and whoever rejects me rejects the one who sent me. And now, dear brothers, who have been chosen by the Lord, consider that you are chosen from among men and appointed on their behalf for the things that pertain to God. The title of bishop is one of service, not of honor. And therefore, a bishop should strive to benefit others rather than lord it over them. Such is the precept of the master. The greater should behave as the least, and the ruler as the servant. Preach the word in season and out of season. Reprove with all patience and sound teaching. As you pray and offer sacrifice for the people committed to your care, devote yourselves wholeheartedly to seeking every kind of grace from them, from the fullness of Christ's holiness. In the church entrusted to you, be faithful stewards, moderators, and guardians of the mysteries of Christ. Since you are chosen by the Father to rule over his family, be mindful always of the Good Shepherd, who knows his sheep and is known by them, and who did not hesitate to lay down his life for them. With the charity of a father and brother, love all whom God places in your care, especially the priests and deacons who are your co-workers in the ministry of Christ, but also the poor and the weak, immigrants and strangers. Exhort the faithful to work with you in your apostolic labor. Do not refuse to listen willingly to them. Never relax your concern for those who are not yet gathered into the one fold of Christ. They too are entrusted to you in the Lord. Never forget that you are joined to the College of Bishops in the Catholic Church, made one by the bond of charity, and therefore you should have constant concern for all the churches and gladly come to the support of churches in need. And so keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit appoints you to govern the Church of God in the name of the Father whose image you represent in the church, in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, whose office of teacher, priest, and shepherd you will discharge, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the Church of Christ and by his power strengthens us in our weakness. The ancient rule of the Holy Fathers ordains that a bishop-elect is to be questioned in the presence of the people on his resolve to uphold the faith and to discharge his duty. And so, dear brothers, do you resolve by the grace of the Holy Spirit to discharge until death the office entrusted to us by the apostles, which we are about to pass on to you by the laying on of our hands?
I do.
You resolve to preach the gospel of Christ with constancy and fidelity?
I do.
You resolve to guard the deposit of faith entire and incorrupt as handed down by the apostles, preserved in the church everywhere and at all times?
I do.
You resolve to build up the body of Christ, his church, and to remain in the unity of that body together with the order of bishops under the authority of the successor of St. Peter the Apostle?
I do.
You resolve to render obedience faithfully to the successor of the blessed Apostle Peter?
I do.
You resolve to guide the holy people of God in the way of salvation as devoted fathers and sustain them with the help of your fellow ministers, the priests and deacons?
I do.
You resolve for the sake of the Lord's name to be welcoming and merciful to the poor, to the strangers, and to all who are in need?
I do.
You resolve as good shepherds to seek out the sheep who stray and gather them into the Lord's fold?
I do.
You resolve to pray without ceasing to Almighty God for the holy people and to carry out the office of high priest without reproach?
I do, with the help of God.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Dearly beloved, let us pray that the kindness of Almighty God in providing for the welfare of the church will grant an abundance of his grace for these chosen ones.
Let us kneel.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us.
Saint Michael,
pray for us.
Holy angels of God,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint John,
pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene,
pray for us.
Saint Stephen,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch,
pray for us.
Saint Lawrence,
pray for us.
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity,
pray for us.
Saint Agnes,
pray for us.
Saint Gregory,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine,
pray for us.
Saint Athanasius,
pray.
And Saint Dominic,
pray for us.
Saint Francis Xavier,
pray for us.
Saint John Vianney,
pray for us.
Saint Catherine of Siena,
pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Jesus,
pray for us.
All holy men and women, saints of God,
pray. Incarnation, Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By your death and resurrection,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By the outpouring of the Holy Spirit,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
Be merciful to us sinners,
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Protect your holy church,
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Keep the Pope and all the ordained in faithful service to your church,
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless these chosen men,
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless and sanctify these chosen men,
Lord, we ask you,
bless, sanctify, and consecrate these chosen men.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bring all peoples together in peace and true harmony.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Comfort with your mercy the troubled and the afflicted.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Strengthen all of us and keep us in your holy service.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God,
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ,
Graciously hear our petitions, O Lord, and pour out upon these, your servants, the power of your blessing, flowing from the horn of priestly grace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all consolation, who dwell on high, and look upon the lowly, who know all things before they come to be, and who laid down observances in your church for the word of your grace, who from the beginning foreordained a nation of the just, born of Abraham, who established rulers and priests, and did not leave your sanctuary without ministers, and who from the foundation of the world were pleased to be glorified in those you have chosen. Pour out now upon these chosen ones the power which is from you, the governing spirit, whom you gave to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the spirit whom you bestowed upon the holy apostles, who established the church in each place as your sanctuary for the glory and unceasing praise of your name. Grant, O Father, knower of all hearts, that these your servants whom you have chosen for the office of bishop may shepherd your holy flock, serving you night and day. May they fulfill before you without reproach the ministry of the high priesthood, so that always gaining your favor, they may offer up the gifts of your holy church. Grant that by the power of the spirit of the high priesthood, they may have the power to forgive sins according to your command, assign offices according to your decrees, and loosen every bond according to the power given by you to the apostles. May they please you by their meekness and purity of heart, presenting a fragrant offering to you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through whom glory and power and honor are yours, with the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Church, now and forever and ever. May God, who has made you a sharer in the high priesthood of Christ, himself pour out upon you the oil of mystical anointing, and may you fruitful with abundance, make you fruitful with the abundance of spiritual blessing. May God, who has made you a sharer in the holy priesthood of Christ, himself pour upon you the oil of mystical anointing and make you fruitful with an abundance of spiritual blessing. receive the gospel, and preach the word of God with all patience and sound teaching. Receive the ring, the seal of fidelity, adorned with undefiled faith, preserved unblemished, the bride of Christ, the Holy Church. Receive the mitre, and may the splendor of holiness shine forth in you, so that when the chief shepherd appears, you may deserve to receive from him an unfading crown of glory. Receive the crozier, the sign of your pastoral office, and keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit has placed you as bishop to govern the Church of God. Receive the gospel and preach the word of God with all patience and sound teaching. Receive this ring, the seal of fidelity, adorned with undefiled faith, preserved unblemished, the bride of God, the Holy Church. Receive the mitre, and may the splendor of holiness shine forth in you, so that when the chief shepherd appears, you may deserve to receive from him an unfading crown of glory. Receive the crozier, the sign of your pastoral office, and keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit has placed you as bishop to govern the Church of God. And to the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, I now present to you Bishop Jeff Haines and Bishop Jim Schuerman. pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable and pleasing to God, our Heavenly Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and
May this oblation, O Lord, which we have presented for your church and for these your servants, newly ordained as bishops, become an offering acceptable to you. And for the good of the flock, may those you have raised up among your people to be high priests be endowed by your gift with apostolic virtues. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son high priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with the royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, govern her throughout the whole world. Together with Francis, our Pope, may your unworthy servant, Blaise, our Metropolitan, and all the College of Bishops here present, all who together, who holding to the truth hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, Jeffrey and James, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogenus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you, and also for your servants, Jeffrey and James, whom you've been pleased to raise to the order of bishops. And in your mercy, keep safe your gifts in them, so that what they have received by divine commission, they may fulfill by divine assistance. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who've gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
Y nosotros, pecadores, siervos tuyos, que confiamos en tu infinita misericordia, admítenos en la asamblea de los santos, apóstoles y mártires, Juan el Bautista, Esteban, Matías y Bernabé, Ignacio, Alejandro, Marcelino y Pedro, Felicidad y Perpetua, Águeda, Lucía, Inés, Cecilia, Anastasia, y todos los santos, y acéptanos en tu compañía, no por nuestros méritos, sino conforme a tu bondad.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through who, him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command informed by divine teaching, together we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of the Lord's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord.
Saddened sighs, blood poured out in every land, wounded people wailing cries lie upon our outstretched hands. Jesus is the way through death, truth beyond the present rage, life unfolding, healing breath. now enfleshed in youth and age.
Amen.
In floods of light, marking us with oil so sweet, clothing us in glorious white. Priest and prophet, spirit led, we are God's own living sign, feeding on this holy bread, drinking of this holy wine.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And let us pray. By the power of this sacrament, O Lord, increase the gifts of your grace in these your servants and bishops, that they may serve you worthily in the pastoral ministry and receive the eternal rewards of faithful stewards. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As Bishop, I chose as my motto, Christ, our light. And I feel very deeply that in my own life, the light of Christ has been mediated to me by family members and friends, parishioners, and diverse ministerial experiences. I thank the many individuals in my life who've helped me to experience the light and the love of the Lord. I thank my teachers, both religious and lay, from St. Joseph Grade School Lyons, who helped to shape my life of faith. I thank the catechists who introduced me to the sacred scriptures and church teachings, and my seminary professors who helped me to continue to seek to understand the limitless depths of the love of God. I especially would like to thank my siblings and family members for your love and support. It was among my family members that I learned the ways of faith, and on this happy day, with love and gratitude, I call to mind my parents, Bob and Bess, who've passed on to the next life and who are certainly celebrating with us with joy. I'd like to thank you, Archbishop Listecki, for accepting me as a brother bishop and for all that you do for our archdiocese. I'm looking forward to working with you in this new role of service. Thank you, Bishop Skilba and Bishop Hying, for serving as co-consecrators today and for your prayers, support, and inspiring ministry. I'd like to thank you, Archbishop Pierre, our Papal Nuncio, for your presence here today. Please communicate my gratitude to the Holy Father for his outstanding ministry to the Church. All praise and thanks to God for his abundant blessings. Estoy muy agradecido por las muchas bendiciones que Dios me ha dado, por el don de mi familia, de mi fe, mi iglesia local, y por las muchas personas que me apoyan en mi ministerio y me ayudan por medio de sus oraciones. Quisiera agradecer al señor Arzobispo Jerome Listecki, Arzobispo de Milwaukee, al señor Obispo Christoph Pierre, el nuncio apostólico, y el Santo Papa por su ministerio a la iglesia local y mundial. Mil gracias. Bendigamos al Señor.
I would like to begin my words of gratitude by extending my heartfelt appreciation to our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for the calling to serve the Church in my new role as bishop. I am humbled and touched by his invitation and profoundly inspired by his witness to the mercy of Jesus Christ. And to our Papal Nuncio, Archbishop Pierre, I need to preface my remarks to you with an apology for my tardiness in answering your phone calls. 5 times you had to call. I have now noted your phone number, and I will answer future calls immediately. Thank you for your perseverance and for making the effort to be with us here today and to represent the Church Universal. It's hard to capture the breadth of people that I want to thank for their contribution in helping to form me in the faith of the gospel. The sisters and lay teachers of St. Elizabeth and Holy Apostles parishes who taught me in Catholic school and catechism classes, the theology professors at Marquette University and St. Francis de Sales Seminary, the priests, deacons, religious and lay ecclesial ministers with whom I have shared ministry, and the multitude of parishioners who comprise the body of Christ present in the parishes I have served. Any good that I have accomplished in my priesthood is a testament to all of you. For the motto I've chosen for my Episcopal coat of arms, I've selected a portion of the passage offering the last words of Jesus Christ to his disciples in the Gospel of Matthew. It is, "And behold, I am with you always." The awareness of the abiding presence of Jesus Christ and his love is the foundation and strength of my life. And the gift of that awareness comes primarily from my family. In particular, my mom and dad, Maureen and Jim, and my siblings, John, Rick, and Ann. Our family was not perfect, but we never knew a day without love in our home. And I believe that's because each and every night when we prayed, our sports-minded family would conclude our prayers, and we always said, God bless our team, we stick together. It is with special affection that I give thanks to you, Archbishop Lestecky, for the affirmation which you've given to my ministry. It was you who took a lowly priest, minding his own business in the peaceful environs of West Bend, and gave him the encouragement to assume the role of rector of your cathedral. I promise you that I will give my heart and soul as your auxiliary bishop to support your mission as shepherd of the flock here in southeastern Wisconsin. Mention also must be made with gratitude to my brother bishops for your sacrifice in coming here today to be a part of this celebration. What a beautiful example of fraternity. Thank you. Bishop Skelba and Bishop Hine, thank you, my dear brothers, my neighbor and former rectory mate across the hall. Thank you for being here today as co-consecrators in the liturgy. And it represents, for me, the bond of friendship, which has always meant so much to me. And last, but most certainly not least, I give thanks to Almighty God, the giver of all good gifts, for the blessing of his saving grace, which brings us all ardent hope and the promise of eternal joy.
I'd like to offer a few additional thank yous to our priests, our consultors, our deans who are here present, pastors, our parish directors, and our deacons. Thank you so much for your service to the church. To the groups in the honor guard today, to the Knights of Columbus, the Knights and Dames of Malta, the Knights and Dames of Peter Claver, to the Knights and Dames of the Holy Sepulchre of Jerusalem. We have a lot of dames in the Archdiocese. And they're all very, very classy individuals. So thank you so much for being a part of the church as we witness to the church in the world. To volunteer seminarians from all of the dioceses of the Providence, Wisconsin, Milwaukee, Green Bay, Madison, La Crosse, and Superior. To our acolytes, we're all seminarians for the Archdiocese of Milwaukee. To our masters of ceremonies, Jim Lobaz, Brad Kravchek, Ugo Londonio, Luke Strand, and Nathaniel Miniot. To cathedral staff and volunteers who so generously have offered their time, as well as to the archdiocese and staff, who volunteer their time to be with us today and to help organize this wonderful liturgical event. And lastly, but of course not least, to the archdiocese choir, directed by Jeff Honore and Michael Baccio as accompanists. They always provide for us a tremendous support to our liturgical service. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May the Lord bless you and keep you, as he has willed to set you as high priest over his people. So may he make you happy in this present life and grant you a share in the happiness that is eternal. Amen. 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 May God grant that the clergy and people he has chosen to unite by his gracious help be happily governed by his providence in your stewardship for many years to come.
Amen.
May they obey God's commandments, freed from adversity, and may they abound in all that is good, submitting in the faith to your ministry, so that they will enjoy peace and tranquility in the present age, and with you be found worthy to share the company of the citizens of eternity.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.